Hey guys, welcome back to Home Built, and today we are going to start tackling the dash on the 680. Okay, before we start, just going over last week's video, just talking about the firing order of the distributor, and I was actually set this up as per this book. That's the book I've used to rebuild the whole car, and for anybody else using this particular book, if you use this diagram that's in the book, it's wrong. So this firing order here is actually incorrect. Basically in this image, 5 and 6 are swapped around. So I've actually gone already through and re-swapped the wires here and straightened out my wire layout. So now I'm all good, but just note that the book's wrong. Okay, so moving on from the engine bay, let's start looking at this dash. Now, I showed you this a couple of weeks ago. I managed to track down this dash, which is quite possibly the original dash from this car. And the very first thing I need to do is just clean it up, because it is absolutely disgusting. So let's tidy it up and just see what we're working with. All right, that is looking good. I have full throttle pedal. It looks like it's working quite well, so we'll see how it goes. I do need to move the fuel line going to the front of the carbies. That's getting caught underneath the throttle, but besides that, the linkages all seem to be doing their job properly, so job done on that. Okay, so I've gone along and I've cleaned out all the glue under this front edge because I wasn't happy with how it was sticking down. I do like the overall look of the dash. I think it's a good workaround. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick on the whole entire front edge of this dash with some Sikaflex. It's black. It sticks like something to a blanket. So I'm going to go through now and do this whole front edge. And hopefully we can leave it overnight or so, and it should, fingers crossed, do the job and finish off this just this front edge, just to make it look like it is a nice, neat, finished item.
Well, my microphone is really playing up in this heat, but the top of the dash is all taped down, so I'm going to leave it over the next few days and just let it set up properly before I see what the results are like. But that's definitely all the time I have today, so I think it's time for Fun Facts with Mrs. Jeff.
Hey guys, at the 1976 Daytona 500, most of the top teams were qualifying with a top speed on the main straight of 178 to 179 miles per hour. What stood out was that the first and second place qualifiers, AJ Foyt and Darrell Waltrip, had top speeds on the main straight of 187 miles per hour. That's 9 miles an hour faster than the rest of the field. This prompted the NASCAR inspectors to take a closer look at these two cars. And they noticed some suspicious-looking extra fuel lines. It turns out both teams were running nitrous oxide to give themselves a qualifying boost. Needless to say, they were both disqualified.
All right, another successful day. The wheels are looking great. I'm really loving the look of these new wheels on the car. And the dash. The dash is actually, I'm pretty confident, it's a reasonable fix for the dash. Some of you might not like it, but I think it's a good compromise. Anyway.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
All right, guys.
Okay, we hope you're enjoying the show. If you are, please like and subscribe and...
Tell your mates.
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah.
Tell your mates, your All friends, right, wives.
Yes. It's a family show. All right, guys.
Bye, guys.
See you next time.
Who knows? I didn't know, and so I'm just going to work with it. 187. I did. No.
Just read it.
Just give me a...